My email signature is looking sexy as thanks to MySignature, and it's thanks to a system that's super easy to build it and start updating it whenever you need to. Let's go check it out right now. The idea of using an email signature is to make your emails more professional, plus you get that added benefit of your branding. People are going to click on those links and they're going to sign up to your channel, they're going to like your fan page, they're going to have a lot more to do with your email than just a plain old email without anything on it. Now, like I said, MySignature is super easy to use and super easy to update it later on if you need to. Now, you can grab a deal that's going on right now, so check out that link in the description. Now, this is my dashboard, and like you saw in that little preview, my email signature is looking super sexy thanks to MySignature. Now, the idea is to show you how easy it is to use MySignature. So let's get started with a brand new one. So let's go into MySignature, I'll start a new one. And the best part of all is that the templates that they have look really good, okay? So you can go ahead and start from scratch if you like, but I suggest starting from a template because they look really nice. Now they have all these templates available, even with banners included inside of them, and you can update these banners super easily. So it's way faster doing it in another way. So doing it this way, it's way faster and easier. So there's a lot of signatures available that you can use. Let's grab one of these that actually has a banner and looks nice. So this is one I use. You can see that there. And I just added my links and my image. So I'll use this one, this guy, which is a travel blogger. It's just the idea, but you can change everything out. Okay, so I'm ready here. This is my builder and I can change the name. So instead of blogger, I'll say SaaS master in this case. And my name is George Aguilar. What's my position? I'm saying I'm CEO, department, content creator. Okay. You can remove anything that you don't want or just add it if you like. Okay. So let's just say, you know what? That doesn't look so nice. I can even add a dash there or just go ahead and remove it. Then we have the contact details. Again, you can add fields or you can remove them. So we have phone, address, and Skype, and I've already added mobile, email, and website. Now, like I said, you can remove one or add one if you like. So if I want to add the phone, I can do so there. And it adds it automatically over here on the preview. So I know how it's going to look. I can also see how it's going to display on dark mode. And it's going to automatically change the font color so it works with dark mode. Then we have the custom fields. So here you can add whatever you want to it. So the field name would be, I don't know, app, right? Let's say I have an app and the field value. I'll add the value there and the link for it. And just like that, I mean, it's easy to add custom fields. So that's that part. Next, I'll jump into images. Now, I can do so by following the tabs on the top, or I can just click on the element and it'll take me right to the section where I need to edit it. So they kind of thought that out when they created this. So now I can change the image, I can remove it, I can change the image size, make it look wherever I want. So for example, yeah, that looks good. And I can add my own link. Oh, sorry, my own image, and I can link the image if I like. So if they click on the image, it'll take them somewhere else. And then we have the banner. This is optional if you want to add it or not, but I think it's super cool to have this. Now, they have some pre-made banners for special occasions, for example, for holidays, for Easter, for Mother's Day. So just adding something like that really quickly, or you can upload your own banner. So basically, if you have a product that you have on sale or something that you want to promote, well, just add the banner and you're good to go. I mean, it makes things super easy to do with MySignature. You can make things more complex by doing it on your own. Now, there's the settings for the link for the banner. You can retrieve the add-ons below or above. So if I want to change it, I can do so there. The banner width, so if I want to make it smaller or bigger, let's just say I want to keep it in size with this. Oh, and by the way, it is mobile friendly and it looks nice on mobile also, okay? So that's for the images. Now the socials. So there's this little social icons here. All I have to do is just add some information here and it starts adding the icon to it. If I don't wanna use it, I can just go ahead and remove it. I can drag it to the top for the ones that I have added. For example, I want to have LinkedIn in the beginning because it's my most important social media account. You just do it there. And obviously add the link to your Instagram account, etc. And then there's a gallery if you want to choose other type of icons for this. And then there's the add-ons. The add-ons I think are super cool and well thought out. For example, if you want to add a sign off for this, you can say holidays, best regards, sincerely, regards, etc. You can change the font here for custom text, font family. There's all these fonts available. Okay, the font size and the font color. If you don't want sign off, just go ahead and remove it. A disclaimer. So I have a disclaimer here. I've added that to my email. Again, you can edit the disclaimer if you like, and there's other type of disclaimers available, data protection, e-commerce, and like I said, they thought out all of this, so it makes it super easy to use. There's the social one. So again, if you wanted some social links here, let's say Facebook, I'll add my Facebook here. And they have different type of Facebook looks. So you don't have to actually use a one that's by default. You can change to a different one right here. So they have some sexy ones here that you can choose. For example, there you go, follow on or follow me, because it could be a company or it could be personal. In my case, it was personal, so it's like follow me, all right? So you have those options available here. You can use invert for different type of looks. See that there? And it looks really nice, right? Then we have the shape, rounded off corners or rounded completely, the size and the padding option. And again, I can go ahead and remove it if I don't want to use it. There's the video conference, so you can add your information here from Zoom, Google Meet, Skype, Google Meeting, etc. All these here, and you have different icons for these, and so on and so forth. The green message, so if you don't want them to print this, just a little friendly message, just say if you are an eco-friendly company, you might want to add something like that. The call to action, if you want to add a call to action to this. There's the event and calendar, so you can add that there also. And marketplace retail. So if you have anything in a store like this, like Amazon, App Store, etc., you can use that there. That looks pretty cool. So for example, if I use this, I'll just type anything so it activates it. See how it's activating it? And you can make it white, you can make it black, grayish, whatever works out for you, rounded, like that. And it's pretty cool that we have that option. So just like that, it's super easy to build your email. Now, how do we implement this email? Well, it's actually super easy. There's several methods that you can use. One is by installing the Chrome extension, doing it here. Plus, it also comes with a tracker, and I'll show you that in a bit. Or you can do it via, let's go ahead and save this design. Go ahead and save it. Okay, and we can install it on these platforms. We're going to get instructions to do it on Gmail, Outlook, custom email, etc., or custom source code. You can use it like that. Another trick I've tested and it works is just grabbing this and pasting it in your email provider for the signature section, okay? So that works also in case you want to do that there. Now, once you have your signature ready, you add it to your email and you're good to go. For example, here's a test email that I've done, and it's just, like I said, test email. And what I've done here is I've actually tested the email to see how it looks, and this is my signature, and also to check out the tracking. So as of now, there's tracking for the amount of read times and the amount of clicks and when it was open. So you have all those analytics available as of now by using the Chrome extension. Be aware, they will be bringing analytics to this in the future. Let me go back into my dashboard. So right now we're in the signature section, reviewing all our signatures, and then we have the analytics. So this is coming soon. So we're gonna have more information to what's happening with the signatures. So it's pretty cool that we have all that available with the deal that's available. Now, like I said, it's super easy to create a signature here and customize it later on if you like. So like I said, if you're offering promotions with a banner, well, what better way to do it with my signature by updating the banner right here without having to go through complex kind of settings or upload somewhere else. You just do it right inside of here, and it's super easy to do it. But there you go. If you want to grab the deals going on, do check it out in the link in the description. I thank you all for watching, and that's a wrap.